So I usually ask the people in front of me to give three nuggets of wisdom to the budding entrepreneur.
You'll get
right?
six.
Okay. I think with Nazar, I ask five.
We'll share.
I want to ask you something different because I want to ask you, what would you tell the budding female entrepreneur? Right.
Three.
What advice would you give her?
Three
the
nuggets.
The 31. Yeah, I give you five lah.
No. Okay. Number one.
Yeah.
Be realistic. All right.
So this applies whether you're a boy or a girl.
Yeah, it does apply whether you're a man or a woman. But I think for the woman, realism I think is extremely important because, like it or not, the woman instinctively will think more about the children than the husband. That's a fact. Okay, so you are trying to run a business, and at the same time, at the back of your mind, you still have this desire to be the best mom possible. A working mom goes through the same thing. I don't know whether men think that way, but for a mother, definitely, instinctively, innately.
The children take precedence over the business?
You know, it's a struggle.
Yeah.
Right, and I think working mothers struggle through this every day, and when you're an entrepreneur, it is just as much of a struggle. And because you're building a business, the real risk is that you can actually drop the kids for the business if it requires it, because the business is depending entirely on you most of the time. If an emergency happens, you'd have to drop everything and go.
Okay, nugget number two.
So, realism. Number two, you must find balance. Easier said than done. But how you achieve balance is by making sure, instead of trying to do everything yourself, you have to grow your team. The only way to grow your team is to start a system. Have a system, train your team to follow the system, and then you just monitor the system. And that's how you achieve balance. And it will take time, but it's worth the investment. Number three, you need to give yourself a break. I think, I'm not sure if the same applies for men, but I think women in particular are very driven to prove something. Yeah, there's this constant...
What do you think that is?
I don't know. I think women have a chip on our shoulder. There's this constant desire to prove something.
Because of the patriarchal superiority?
I still haven't exactly put a finger on it, but there's this constant desire to prove something. I can do it all. And then you open magazines and
for
you say superwomen.
For those that can feel that way, right?
Yeah, and we are also surrounded by magazines that tell us that women can have it all and can do it all, and that's not true. You need to be able to know when to step back and tell yourself, I need a break. And if I didn't do that, I would have had a nervous breakdown.
Yeah.
You know, and you need to be able to say to yourself, stop. And you need to be honest with your partners and tell them, I'm struggling here. You know, I need more input from you guys. You know, that would be the three main nuggets. Yeah. And I think number four and number five is, number four, be true to yourself and your business. Because if you're not, then your business is going to lose its moral compass. And I think for me, I'm not sure whether this is a women thing or whether this is just me per se. Once a business and a person and the founder loses their moral compass, then it's very easy for your business to become like everything else out there.
I.e. the mission and vision statement.